Dear friends, welcome to another Arduino project video. Today we are going to build a simple weather station using a BME280 sensor and an LCD shield. Let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266 and other popular ports. Today we are going to take a first look at the new BME280 sensor, a new very interesting sensor. We are going to build a simple but very accurate weather station project. I have built a similar project 2 years ago using different sensors. Now that we have a new sensor available which makes things easier, it's time to update the project. As you can see, on the LCD display, we can see the temperature, the humidity, and the barometric pressure. The readings are updated every 2 seconds. This is a very easy project to build, so it is ideal for beginners. Let's build it. The parts needed in order to build this project are the following: an Arduino Mega, a BME280 sensor, an LCD shield for Arduino, and some wires. The cost of the project is around $18. You can find links for all the needed parts in the description of the video. Let's connect all the parts. At first, let's take a quick look at the new BME280 sensor. The sensor is very small and it can measure temperature, humidity, and barometric pressure. Great! The cost of the sensor is about $5. So far in our weather station projects we were using the BME180 sensor, which can measure temperature and pressure, but not humidity. There is also the BME280 sensor, which does not offer humidity measurements, so be careful when ordering the sensor. We need the BME280 sensor. The board I have bought uses the I2C interface, so we only need to connect 4 wires to make it work. Let's connect the sensor to Arduino. We are using the Arduino Mega today, but you can use the Arduino Uno as well if you solder some header pins to your LCD shield. The Arduino Mega makes things easier for beginners, so we connect the LCD to the Arduino Mega like this. Then we connect the V-in pin of the sensor to the Arduino Mega 5V output here. Next, we connect the ground pin of the sensor to the Arduino Mega ground. The next step is to connect the SEL pin of the sensor to the SEL pin of the Arduino Mega and the SDA pin of the sensor to the SDA pin of the Arduino Mega. That's it! If we load the code and power up the project, we can see that after 2 seconds, the readings from the sensor are displayed on the screen. Our project is ready. You can now build your own enclosure for it and you have a very accurate weather station. Let's now take a look at the code of the project. The code of the project uses 3 libraries. We need to download 2 of them since the third one is already installed with the Arduino IDE. We need to download the Adafruit BME280 library and the Adafruit sensor library. Let's see how to install the BME280 library. We visit the library website and we download it by clicking here. We unzip it in our Arduino libraries folder and we rename it like this. We follow the same procedure with the sensor library as well. You can find links for all the libraries in the description of the video below. Now that we have installed the libraries, we need to define the altitude for our location in meters in order to get accurate barometric pressure readings. As you can see, the code is very simple. At first, we initialize the sensor and the display. In the loop function, we read the sensor every 2 seconds. After reading the sensor, we print the values on the display. In this version of the code, we display the temperature in degrees Celsius, but I have also prepared a version of the code with the temperature measured in degrees Fahrenheit. You can find both versions of the code of the project in a link in the description below. That's today's project, an Arduino weather station project with a new BME280 sensor. The new BME280 sensor is very easy to use since it uses the I2C interface. I am going to use it a lot in the future projects because it offers temperature, humidity, and pressure sensors in one package. This makes our weather station projects easier to build and more compact. I would love to hear your opinion about this sensor. Are you going to use it in any of your projects? If yes, what kind of projects are you going to build using this sensor? Please post your ideas below. I would love to read them. Thanks! If you are new to the channel, I would love to have you subscribed by clicking on the channel icon here, because every Saturday I post a new video about do-it-yourself electronics and robot projects. I hope you will join our community. See you next week!